Good evening. The missing persons squad has taken over the hunt for Samantha Murphy 6 days after the Ballarat mum vanished on her morning run. The search area has almost doubled in size, with extra police called in as the mystery deepens.
After nearly a week of searching and nothing to show for it, police are shaking up the investigation.
I can confirm that this morning the missing persons squad have taken over investigation primacy in relation to the disappearance of Samantha.
To date, detectives still have no leads on Samantha Murphy's movements since she left the family home for a run on Sunday morning.
We're in our sixth day of the operation. We've covered a lot of areas so far, so we're just expanding our search area.
The search initially focused on bushland near the family home in Ballarat East. From there, it expanded up to 8 kilometres away to Mount Helen. Today, search efforts moved even further south to private land at Buninyong, 14 kilometres away. That's well outside her usual running range.
The remoteness of the areas that we're looking at, there's not a lot of CCTV in residential or business premises, so dash cam footage is the one that we really need. A lot of people have dash cam footage in their cars.
From today, there are more detectives assigned to the case, which becomes more desperate with each passing day.
We have not identified any suspicious or sinister circumstances. However, we do hold significant concerns for Samantha's welfare at this stage, and that is growing as the days progress.
One of the few leads police have is Samantha's last phone signal, which pinged off a local tower.
Strange that the phone hasn't pinged again. They'll be relying heavily on phone, her Apple Watch.
Samantha's husband, Mick, spoke with police again this morning as the investigation moved into a new stage.
I think the longer it goes on, the more sinister it becomes. So they'll be talking to friends, relatives, family to try and establish her movements.
Absolutely, that'll be a huge part of our investigation, digging into the background, working out Samantha's movements in the days leading up to her disappearance, and also the people that know her.
The number of people following the search has soared. Cindy Hobbs started the Find Samantha Murphy Facebook page. It now has 14,000 members.
We've had messages from the UK, Oklahoma. It's really going international.
Closer to home, Anglican minister Reverend Mark Shering has opened his church to concerned community members.
People are well and truly struggling, but coming together, as any community will do, and just looking for ways in which they can help.
They, like police, are hoping for answers about how a 51-year-old mother could vanish without a trace, particularly one so healthy and happy.
She's physically and mentally a fit and strong woman.
And Geordie Wright is at Buninyong this evening. Geordie, it's been a frustrating day for police.
Mitch, hundreds of people have been scouring the Buninyong area all day but have found nothing. For the first time, police turned their focus to private property searching farmland. Tomorrow, police resources will be increased yet again. Detectives pledging sooner or later they will find answers, Mitch.
Geordie Wright at Buninyong, thank you.